Hi everyone, happy Sunday. So, I decided that I am inspired to jump on the call real quick to share an experience, a real experience I had this morning. I was scheduled to teach a class as a trainer, and I had my material all prepared. I know exactly what I want to talk about. I even, practiced so many times and really got to know my material really well before my training session. And of course, when I log on to the meeting app or the conference call, it turns out that they are not using the program that I'm really used to, so I use Zoom all the time to do conferencing. But when it comes to doing the workshop for someone else, I was using the GoToMeeting, which I am not familiar with GoToMeeting. So this is actually my first time using GoToMeeting to train a class. And so, of course, I was there and I started my training. I have all my material, my portion of the material all prepared, and I got onto the computer and I wanted to share the screen. I didn't know how to share the screen, and for some reason my computer just wouldn't work. So I was in that moment where, oh my gosh, what do I do? How do I have a room full of people, and I mean a room full of people. And so I have all these people on the call, and they're all waiting for me to deliver my training session, my program, my workshop. And so I was sitting there and I went into this panic mode. I'm thinking to myself, oh gosh, what if it doesn't work? And what is wrong with my computer? I got so frustrated and I kept going to the privacy setting and hoping, hi, how? I was hoping that the program would work, but it didn't. So in that moment, I was going through, there's tons of thoughts that was just going and flowing through my mind. And finally, luckily, someone from the audience happened to be an engineer. And so he was able to help me with some technical part. And he said, well, try this and that. So he walked me through like, how do you set it up? And I was able to share my screen and start the whole workshop. So the point is that no matter how calm you are or how prepared you are in doing a presentation, there's always going to be those moments where you get caught off guard. So it could be as small as a technical difficulty, it could be small as something, maybe someone blur out something and you found it very offensive or emotional, or you become emotional during your speech or during your presentation. So what do you do in those situations, and how do you really stay calm so that you can continue and focus on what needs to be done? So I end up jumping, turning on my mic. I was muted before. I was doing all this busy work in the front, and so I turned on my mic and I told everyone, let's go and take a break. And because everyone had been sitting for the last hour and a half, so let's go ahead and take a break. And when you come back, I will be ready for you. So when you are in a room full of people, or when you are doing your presentation, and something went wrong that requires your attention, a good idea to break that energy or break that negativity or breaking that thoughts is actually to put a break, right? So you can put a break. If you're the presenter, you can put a break by offering people, hey, let's take 5 minutes break and let's come back and resume in 5 minutes. And after that 5 minutes, you may resolve anything, any challenges or any obstacle that you may experience in that time, and you allow people to actually get up and break that energy of frustration that you are sending out to your audience. So that's a great strategy. If you ever find yourself getting stuck in fixing a technical problem during your presentation, give people a break. Just tell your audience and say, hey, we're having a little technical difficulty. Let's take a 5 minutes break and let's come back in 5 minutes and I will be ready for you. So that's a great strategy, and it's just giving people a break. And how do you stop your negative thoughts in that moment? Well, again, you actually had that ability to give yourself a break, give yourself permission. Everybody makes mistakes. You don't have to be perfect in doing your presentation. And this is the moment where you tell yourself, actually, all the training that we have gone through in training our muscle of giving ourselves permission to make mistakes, this is a great time to allow yourself to have that permission to make a mistake. You know what? I am not familiar with the technical part of this go-to meeting, and therefore I'm going to take about 5, 10 minutes and just to learn how to operate it and so that I can deliver my presentation. So these are the two strategies that I would definitely wanted to share with you so that in case you ever experience something that doesn't work out right, it's the universe time, it's the universe way of telling you to take a break and just really reevaluate where you are and where you want to go from here and on. So that's my little 5 minutes, 6 minutes tip. Hope you all have a wonderful Sunday night, and I will see you next week. Bye!